Finding the herbalist was the most pressing matter. A healing herb needed to be taken to Mary as soon as possible.
Some had invested this object with great power.
was still with energy, coiled and ready to let loose. This mushroom was vital to any concoction for the purpose of healing. While naturally poisonous, any skilled brewmaker could extract the important properties without danger.
Eyes.
The heat had only grown more intense in the young child's hands. Far stronger than any would suspect in one so young. Her training could no longer be just a pastime, for fire was a dangerous friend. Margaret knew full well that signs and symbols were seldom obvious and never direct. She was certain that the cause of the corruption would be difficult to discover. The past holds both joy and bitterness of time. Sheila could help them, as John said, but Ben could not bring himself to overlook the sting of their past relationship. The origin of the threat of corruption was what occupied most of Grandma's time lately. When pressed, Mountain God was the only answer Grandma gave. All eight. Making mistakes was part of learning, no matter how talented you are. Lucy was feeling disheartened. Once more, she had better mastery of fire this time. But wait, disaster was about to happen. Thankfully, her father intervened in time. Old tales and amusing stories. The Bergsons well knew that even in the darkest of hours, they would lighten a heavy heart. And furthermore, maybe those heroes of old could teach something of their ways to the heroes of now while they listen to the trove of Grandma Margaret's stories.
In the center, an object touched by the gods. The poor herbalist had no valuables, but the goblin's greed had now surpassed gold and jewels. Shedding tears for the dead man
but served no one now. The herbs needed to be delivered to Mary. Vibrated with the pilgrims' chanted prayers, prayers offered to a deity that perhaps slumbered, unhearing, at the end of their journey. The hero did not know how many of them would survive the coming days. Adam writes about how he and the gang found more than they set out to find.
Thank you.
The creature that now threatened the hero was a crudely focused inferno of hatred and malice. One raging beast was not enough. Surely, two were. The second beast became motionless. The poor creatures, twisted by the corruption, were finally able to rest. A path to be cleared of the corruption, and the jewel of life to be restored, the realm of Anea Dia, mother of beasts and the goddess of waters. Before embarking for the spirit halls, family must be informed of the newly opened passage. The goblin siblings lay dead, and the pilgrims were now safer in their caves. But the last step remained to be taken. The warriors knew only that somewhere in the expanse of the caves was the ancient halls of the spirit who would reveal new truths to them. Mark was out of the woods now, his fever gone. He was almost up and about. "Welcome back, brother," said Kevin. He had avoided conflict over the years, living in harmony with nature. But as Uncle Ben was fond of saying, a Berkson would forget how to walk before they forget how to fight. Whenever he could find time, Mark was reading about herbs and salves, his interest in medicine inherited from his grandmother. The first guest to be summoned, Anai Daya, was to be found in the darkest depths of the Kaldipo caves. For a spirit to leave her domain, though, was no simple task. Can the body endure the mind's gamble? Thank you. Lucy was barely containing her excitement as Margaret continued to train her patiently. When will be the time? When? She kept asking. To the excitable and talented child, few chores were as boring as practice. But the fire child still needed more. Wherever there was a secret, knowledge was to be gained in reward. And wherever there was a reward, danger lurked. The cipher was important enough that it brought Grandma here. "Here's to being lucky," Grandma exclaimed with her unique sense of humor. creature of inanimate stone, given life by the power of the mountain god and presented to the mother of beasts. Rama knew they needed to get past it to get to Aneadaya's halls to discover more about the connection between the god and the corruption. Bergson's hair stood on end from the ominous sounds.
Thank you. Thank you.
inhaled softly, a blessing from the gods.
Thank you.
There could not have been a more perfect description of this route than its name, Cave Web. Rather bland to the taste, it was still edible and full of nutrients. Before the hero was a game of chance and memory.
Come on.
mother of beasts and goddess of anguish. A protector, being of stone made living. Lucy was trying to convince Grandma that she could face the corruption on her own, despite having doubts herself. She might be able to persuade Margaret, but Mary was another story. Grandma would say, "Trust the children," and convince Mary. But Lucy knew that her mother would still worry. everybody was worried about a Neadiah's stone sentinel that they would probably have to face on their quest. "Can fire even harm stone?" Lucy asked intently. Kevin was having similar thoughts about the alloy Uncle Ben had used to forge his daggers. Dizzy, nauseated, feverish. The Bergson's mind unsettled from the incremental rise of the corruption. No longer were even they immune to its ill effects. The time had come at last. She could finally fight real enemies, afraid but excited. The younger daughter of the Bergsons wondered if she would pass this test. I did it. I did it, said Lucy when she met Grandma. Margaret's proud smile signaled the end of Lucy's training. She now had to return home to tell her mother and hopefully put some of her worries to rest. Passing through, the hero could put weapons aside for a moment. Summoners in a circle. Surely nothing would come from it. A greater enemy, but also a greater reward. temporary reprieve offered by the gods, and a prize waiting. Adam describes how their group sought Anaidaya for her wise counsel. Grandma arrived in time to reveal the contents of the tablet. The secrets of Rhea are in the hearts of the stones, and for those whose weapons guard the creatures of the wild, there are new arts of war to be learned. She flaunted her wings, begging to be chased. Do not linger. Bellagio fled further, cornered in this game of cat and mouse. Yeah.
monstrous creature shouldn't keep me from finding the cure for the little cub, the Bergson thought.
One fungus bulb harvested, not the most pleasant of smells, but would give bite and power to any remedy. Hold on just a little longer, young cub. The gods offered this, for the hardships at least.
Yeah.
Breaking the circle would prevent the summoning. Grandma was already there, as always, before the Bergson could have a look around. Those who approach the light will gain more valuable experiences, was how the tablet was explained. finally free of the corruption's hold, Anaya Dyer gazed upon the Bergson, her emerald eyes weary with exhaustion. The spirit's words took life, forming images to reveal what was hidden from the Bergsons. And us, spirits three, knelt before the mountain god Uu to swear fealty. Our wills were set on peace. His was set on testing ours. And as the test drew to a close, we discovered our wretched ending. Mountain God exacted vengeance on the children of Rhea Dana and tainted Rhea with the corruption. Thus was another truth revealed to the Bergson, but many more were hidden still. Questions were abundant in the Bergson's mind. If the mountain god was the source of the corruption, what had made him wreak such havoc? How had no one known about him before? They needed to find the next spirit, as maybe they had an answer to some of their... And now the Fire Child was ready. As if night had become day, the cub showed no signs of its past struggles, with Lucy and he now simply dancing the day away. If the little wolf cub was to stay, it would need a room and bed of its own. All too happy to build it, Ben only required some wood and nails from nearby. Why would the mountain god corrupt the world? What kind of evil was it that brought it forth? For Margaret, these questions were as important. Nairaha, spirit of fealty, awaited the Bergsons somewhere in Berahat. Next portal, take the warriors there. Once a lively place of merchants, was now only a back alley of broken promises and death. Deep in the city of thieves, the path to Nairaha's halls awaited.
Yeah!
compensation bestowed by the gods.
Thank you.
Linda felt a deep sorrow. She saw that her tree, the tree her father had planted the day she was born, had withered and died. Though when she looked upon her grandma, her sadness lessened. Margaret was always a glimmer of light in the darkest of hours.